Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us start the fourth unit of a cloud computing, guys. Okay. So the first topic in this unit is about the issues with portability and interoperability, guys. So if you recall, in unit 1, we already discussed about these two topics, like at least the challenges, in challenges we discussed, guys. Anyway, I'll be revising you, don't worry, okay? Yes. So firstly, let us go through the cloud portability. So what is that basically means? And what does cloud interoperability mean? So we'll be discussing about these two definitions clearly in this lecture, guys, okay? Yes. So please concentrate for 2 to 3 minutes at max, that's it, okay? Yes. So let us start. Okay. So what is a portability, guys? Did you have ever heard the word portability or portable? So, if you are a programmer or if you are interested in programming, in Java, when you are preparing for your SEM exams or when your faculty told, always they point out a point that Java is portable, Java is portable, Java is portable. It's quite a common word, right? Yes. So, the reason why they say Java is portable because, so if I write a Java code in my Windows system, okay, and if I send that file to my friend's system, which is a Mac system. Okay, so without any modifications in that code, he can run it, guys. That is the main reason why Java is portable. Okay, so in the same way, if you can transfer your project, so basically assume that you did a project on a cloud, okay, a cloud computing website, so you did a project. If you can transfer your project to some other cloud provider, okay, if it is possible, then it is called as a, then your service is portable, guys. Got it? That concept of migrating from one cloud server or one service provider to another service provider is called as portability. Okay? Yes. So now let us go through the theory. So I wrote again 3 definitions. So you can select any one of them. The ability to migrate application, runtime or data between clouds is called as portability. So in between clouds we are doing. Okay? Similarly, portability is ability is about the ability to move an entire an entity from a system to another system without compromising its utilities. So basically, you should not do any modification after transferring, guys. Your website should run 100% smoothly. Only then you can say that the migration is done 100% properly and efficiently. Okay? Yes. Similarly, the last definition which I wrote is the ease with which a system component, data or users can be transferred from one hardware to software environment to another. So basically transferring or migrating, guys, in simple words, okay? That is a cloud portability, okay? So now let us go through cloud interoperability. Okay, so what is the meaning of interoperability, guys? So in between something, you can operate things, right? Yes. So that kind of meaning is nothing but interoperability, right? Yes. So it is some kind of thing where a single task can be broken into 2 parts. Okay. And these 2 parts combinedly will give you the result. So that kind of concept. So basically these 2 clouds are interlinkably operating in a proper way to fulfill your task. So that concept is nothing but interoperability. Okay. Yes. Okay. The ability of same or different applications running on different clouds to collaborate. So basically, 2 applications are running, or 1 application, so half part is running in one cloud and the other half is running in other cloud. So at that time, both of these clouds combinedly will perform the application, will form the full application. So if they are running in a proper and efficient way, then you can say that both the cloud providers are having good strategy and they are interoperable. Okay? Yes. Similarly, between different public clouds or public clouds and private clouds. Okay. Yes. It might be in between public or public private. Got it? Yes. Guys, anyway, we'll be discussing about these definitions, like what is this public cloud, what is this private cloud, in the next lecture. Don't worry. Okay. Yes. So in cloud computing, interoperability can be described as the ability of 2 or more systems or applications interact to communicate by exchanging information and delivering expected output by processing those exchanged information. So basically 2 clouds will exchange the information, whatever they need, and they will form a final result. So that concept is nothing but the interoperability, guys. Okay. So I hope everyone got some basic idea about interoperability and portability, right? Yes. So in the next lecture, let us go through some issues, guys. So basically, will there be any issues? So I think everyone knows that the popular issue will be vendor lock-in. So about that, we'll be discussing some introduction, you can say, in the next lecture, guys. Okay? Yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.